Because we're live. Yeah. I don't see anything yet either, and it says we're live.
Oh, yep, there we go.
There we go.
Oh. Now it's not showing it. It showed us for like a split second.
Did it go to my AFK screen?
The big face? Oh, no, now it's back.
Okay.
The big scary Egyptian face, yes.
The statue, yeah. All right, so we are live. Sparkling says she can see and hear us. So I'm going to take that as we're a go. You said we're good, so I'm going to take that as a go.
Hello? But when I said we're good, it's... Let me double check.
Hello, everyone. This is Fiendish with Dimension Turing, and I'm here today with Oddzilla.
Rawr.
Fablight, rawr. Yep. And today, for today's Tips and Tricks Live, we're going to talk about roofing. Getting into some of the nitty-gritty of actual construction. Before that, just a reminder that the Radical Botanical Contest closes tonight at midnight. The 29th at midnight. Mine's going to be open a little bit early because midnight server is 3 o'clock in the morning my time. And I don't plan to be up at 3 in the morning. Next week, we'll be touring those entries on the roadshow with Bella Rosa. And we'll be starting at a little bit later time. You may know she's in Australia. So 11 server is way early for her. We'll be going at 2 p.m. server instead of 11.
Oh, that's just way too late for me, though.
Well.
Nobody cares.
Sorry. Midnight on the 29th would be in 10 hours. So I'm here with the pre-made roofing pieces that we have. We've got 3 whole pre-made pieces of roofing. We've got the standard rooftop, which is what I'm standing on. Roof panels, which are useful for a lot more than just roofing. Yeah, P-E-E-K is the correct spelling.
P-E-E-A-K-K-K.
Yeah, that's the redneck spelling. And then the roof corner. I honestly totally dislike the roof corner just because of the corner pieces.
This little dinky corner piece here?
Yeah, the little dinky corner piece. The best way I've ever found to alleviate that is like with a plane or like a rectangle or something to set at the base of it and just kind of hide the gap between this corner and the wall. The only times I've even used the roof corners have been in like a Sanguine Shores build to try to save some item limit on those end pieces. Used to use these a lot, because most of the time when it comes to a roof, I just don't normally put a whole lot of effort. For most builds, I don't put a whole lot of effort into the roof itself. The problem with these is it looks like it's a standard 45 degree angle.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but it's not. It's so now you run
don't
into
get me started, girl.
So you run into a lot of problems on this piece. By trying to line up things like triangles inside of it just as a simple filler, because it is about a degree off. And a degree normally wouldn't be that big of a deal until it is. Like when you're trying to do something really precise. Now these things, they do spin out for nice tower tops. I will use them for that. Any of these pieces here. And as far as these, they make good, like, wall edges, porches, you know, any kind of extra filler piece. And then, of course, you can take all those pieces, and if you want to, say, build your own Methosian-style house or Stonefield Tavern or whatever, you can, since they're all the same thickness, they actually blend together pretty well. And then the only problem that you run into is trying to fill in these odd shapes. And that's always where the big item count comes from, is not necessarily from doing the skeleton of the roof, but filling in of the sides.
I'm trying to fill the damn thing in.
Yeah. So this, you know, you don't have to use the pre-made roofing pieces to make a roof, and you don't even have to use the roofing building blocks. You can use, the beauty of a dimension is you can use whatever you want, whether it's even to atypical materials. I'm not going to go into atypical materials for this stream just because I don't think we have a lot of time for that. I'm going to talk about like which chair makes the best pagoda roof. Dark stripe.
Keep it simple, stupid.
Yeah.
I'm trying to learn, you know, today.
How you shift staircases around to make a roof out of those. Now this is just
my brain.
This is just a standard roof right here. It's a 45 degree, it's a pitch of 45 degrees. So all I have to do to fill it in is slap a triangle in there and call it done. And I wasn't really worried about the grain line with some of the materials, and especially like some of the new roofing blocks. Let me find some here. And of course they're hidden underneath my chat. So let me make some adjustments here. That bag.
Looks like you've made a little bit of plat since last time we streamed. You looked a whole 286.
Yeah. I think I made it for you.
Buy me stuff, please. I don't have the notoriety.
So here's some of the roofing building blocks, which are good for a whole lot more than just making roofs. Tassiera remarked that she likes the brown shingle and the green scale. The green scale's okay. I use the
brown shingle. It looks like it was like part of a gingerbread house roof that melted. Like all these random shapes just drive me batshit crazy.
Well, my particular favorite is probably this one here.
The brown shingles?
The grayscale.
Oh, okay. Thought we were gonna have a brawl on the live stream.
No. Not just because it looks like a snake skin to me, but I like it because it's not as punishing for the direction of all those lines and squiggles and stuff. Like you could take, say, this piece right here, which is flickering madly, and change all these wood triangles out to the grayscale, and it's not going to be that noticeable like it would be with something that has a grain as pronounced as these brown shingles. And that grain is the only thing that makes working with these difficult. Like, say, if I want to set this one to 45 and then put an alternate piece up that's minus 45, then I'm going to have my shingles run in opposite directions. I mean, if you don't care about that, that's fine.
We all care. Everybody cares.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure everybody does care. I know my OCD kicks in on stuff like that. And I don't even have OCD.
I got a lot of I don't give a shit in me, and even I care.
Yeah. It's just like the brick patterns when they run crossways from each other. That really just bothers me.
I can't even look at you.
So the easiest way to do this is, you know, you take, however you build, either from the top down or the bottom up, you can take your rectangles scaled appropriately. And sometimes it's easier to build the roof before you build the rest of the house or whatever it is that you're building. Because roofing is going to work the same way no matter what it is that you make. It's just all in like the style or how it's going to all tie together. Or, you know, the roof is not really the most important part of the overall design.
But if you jack the roof up, you'll mess up the entire build.
Yeah, and if you... Yes, I would agree with that statement. So this is just like taking two pieces, one at plus 45, one at minus 45. And then to do the cross piece, all I did was copy the first two and offset it 90 degrees and then shift it into place. And sometimes you'll want like gables or whatever, and you can do it that way too.
What are gables?
Huh?
What are gables?
Gables are like, say I've got this, like these two pieces right here that I'm running across would be considered gables. They're just like additional roof pieces.
Okay.
There are also things like this right here, this little chunk that I've got sticking out here. And this is nothing but two squares and a triangle to make this. If I was planning on actually having a room up here, there would be a lot more I would need to do on the inside to try to line that up, or at least, clean it up from the inside, and this would all be done with triangles instead of squares to minimize what's going on inside. But this is like basic. I use a roof like this probably in 90% of the houses I build. 'Cause there's always ways you can just spruce up a plain 45 degree roof. And obviously I didn't take a lot of time when I did this model 'cause I got pieces of triangle sticking out. But you can like run planks or whatever up along the eaves to add some kind of decorative element. And I'm still not aligning. I mean, it wouldn't, you'd want a contrasting material, I'm sure, but that was just what I had easily accessible in my bag. But contrasting material would, help give it a little bit of flair, make it easier. Because most visitors to a house are not really going to be looking too much at the roof, unless it's a like an atypical roof, like some of the ones that Holly does with the
Yeah,
swoops.
those are little masterpieces in themselves.
Yeah, with the swoops and arches and I mean, everybody has their own building style, and don't get me wrong, I love the way Holly builds. I'm just typically not going to spend that kind of items on a roof.
The patience for that crap.
So this roof here, I moved on to the next example. This roof here is what's called a gambrel roof. I was looking on Google, I was like, I want to see how to make a barn roof. Well, now you know the technical term, it's a gambrel. The
Barn
gam
is just so much easier to remember.
Yeah, it is. It is, but Google Images had actual specs, like the degrees and how tall it was and everything else, which I didn't really care about the dimensions. I cared about the angle of the center and then the angle of the sides.
Are you going to tell us angles?
Yes, I am.
Okay.
So I've already like rotated it a couple times. It was 60 degrees for this top piece, and then this down here went down to about 50. You come in 10 degrees for each side. So so there's that. We're gonna rotate it. So if it's 60, then I always double check, like to see, because different pieces angle in different directions. So I'm just going to rotate it 30, and then oh, I don't want to offset 90. it over. Whoa, I don't like that. So I'm going to go to the offset calculator. And it's going to tell me, because it's, how can you not care about the dimensions in a dimension stream?
He's being a smartass.
Oh, okay. So the offset calculator, now when it comes to doing rotational offsets, because I want these all to line up, you know, I want it to make a straight line. Now, why not use a rectangle? Well, I tried using a rectangle, and for this example, because I did save it as a set, the rectangle wasn't working out for me. It's too wide. Even if I scale it to where it has the same thickness as these planks, which is 8. So I want to put that in copy and paste, and then approximately 4. Now for here, I need to make sure that I change the offset so that it's going in the minus in the Y axis. Let me make sure it's selected. So now that made that V perfectly spaced, so there's no overlap, no flicker. The reason why this example is flickering like crazy is because I've got 2 sets of planks, because I was fiddling with the length. Then I want to move all of this. Raise it up some.
So you did that whole thing in planks?
Yeah.
I was thinking those were rectangles. Damn!
Yeah, I was trying to do the top part. I was trying to do it in rectangles, but they're not... They were too wide. Even though a size 8 rectangle is not that long. Or not that wide. So... So it looks like I need to come in a little bit more. And of course, you know, you can eyeball it and set it to however you want. Remember I said I wanted to pull it in 10 degrees. Oh, that's not. No, that's bad. We'll just go back to 50. All right. Some of that's just going to be, you know, whatever your aesthetic preference is. However you want to set the angles. Because again, the item count's not going to come so much from the skeleton of the roof itself. It's going to come from however you fill it in. And I always like to try to set up both of the first ribs so that then, minus 80 would work. Minus 70 is where I was at. Either way, so we don't spend a lot of time just on this one thing. Now, how did I determine that it was a transform Z? Well, I pushed the right buttons until I got the offset. I pushed buttons until I got the offset that looked right. Is the honest answer. And I mean, that's basically it. You don't have to use planks. You can use tiles. You can use rectangles. You can use whatever you want to. That's going to work best for you and whatever your build is. Now, how would you fill this thing in? Again, if you don't care about grain lines, the easiest way is probably going to be to triangle it up. A lot of people don't like triangles so much. They don't know what, you know, they don't understand what's the purpose of a triangle, how handy they can be. And I'm just doing like random sizes here. I'm trying to get a... Okay, so... Because my whole thing with all of these has been to try to do this without too much math. So as long as I don't have corners poking out, it's all good.
That's exactly, that is pretty much exactly how I do my roofing, is I just wiggle, man. Looks good.
Pretty much. You could use an add-on for everything. I honestly, sometimes it's faster to just do it by hand and eyeball it. Ah, that was jacked up. Why did I do that? Why did you let me do that?
Because I wasn't paying attention.
Obviously. There we go. Now the angle's right. So, as you can see again, if you don't... The offset... Okay. Tassier said, I've been afraid of the offset calculator. The offset calculator is nothing at all to be afraid of. It makes things so much easier. Like, lining up these planks. I mean, granted, there's some trial and error involved... But there's trial and error involved in anything. Full of stuff in circles, yes. So, that's the down and dirty way to do like the barn style roof. Obviously, this one wasn't made as carefully as the first one was. That's because I made it the first time. And I saved it as a set at that point because I was like, I don't want to do this ever again.
And for those of you that are terrified of some of these features of this add-on, Fiendish has some really incredible tutorials that she updated for Tinker Tools, and they're in her YouTube channel, accessible at any time if you would like to learn.
Been so much stupider trying to fill in the... Well, sometimes it's not a thing of being stupid, it's just trying to figure out how to do it in a way that's going to look good and not eat up a whole lot of items. Holy crap, you're killing me.
I'm sorry, I'm trying so... I'm typing like so... Oh my god. And it's a Chiclet keyboard, so I don't even have long strokes. I'll just back way away from the microphone. I'm so sorry, guys.
She's like angry typing.
I talked to my brother because he got me the mic, but he didn't get me the shock mount that goes above my head. So.
Usually put the point where the high point of the roof is and then futz around filling in more items than what you just showed. Yes. We'll get to that when we talk about how to do like a steep angled roof. Now this is the same thing as it was basically with those pre-made pieces. It's just at it's a much steeper pitch here. This is like a 30 degree pitch here, and then coming down to I think 40. So again, you know, you'd want to try to make this as painless as possible. But then when you start talking about unusual pitches, then you start talking about like gaps and stuff up at the seam. So we're not going to fill this one in because it's got the same angle as this one does. And I put another little gable on here, like if it's, say, sticking out a little bit. This is some tiles, a triangle, and a cube. Again, it's not trying to be open on the inside. Now, there's different ways where you could fill in a steep angle like that. This one uses three triangles. This is if I don't care. about grain lines. So I've got three triangles that are rotated to the same, the two walls. I hate limestone. Tassier said limestone is your friend. I hate limestone. God, I hate limestone. And limestone also has a grain on it in case they're going in different directions. It's real subtle, but it is there. So these are also set at 30 degrees or 150, whichever. And then a bottom one to fill it in. And then on the top, to fill in the top and make it not look like there's a big gap at that seam, I've got poles running. Yeah, planes. Every block has some kind of grain or some kind of differing texture per side. You know, it you may not notice it until the light hits it just so. But they, all of them, plain stone, granite, limestone, yeah. And limestone, like I say, every time, limestone shows every gap, every flicker, every mismatch, and it's just a real pain in the butt to try to work with. So this one, steep pitch roofs, they look nice. I'm not gonna lie, I like making steep pitched roofs, especially for houses, because I think they're a little bit more distinctive than the normal standard 45. But these poles, running poles along every seam, really starts to tack on to the item limit. And then however you want to fill them in. I do a lot of houses in brick because I like
those. And again, if you're not somebody who uses 20 chairs to make a single bowl, you can probably afford to throw a couple poles on top of your roof.
It's not 20, it's like 12.
Mm-hmm. Still double digits.
Yeah. So, if you don't care about the grain line or the grain line isn't totally obvious, three triangles will fill it in. Or, again with the triangles, this makes like a Christmas tree shape. And then the grain is running the same direction. Now, one thing I did do on this end, I added these planks in here so that I wouldn't have to add as many triangles, because you're not only trying to fill in the gap, you're trying to not have it all be poking out the sides of the roof. Did that make sense? Odds?
I muted myself again. It made sense. In fact, I actually blurted out that the Christmas tree comparison, actually that like made a light bulb go on for me at least.
Yeah.
That's how you need to set it up in order to get it to slide in there.
And this side, I think this end looks a lot cleaner than the other end. And it does.
No comment. One of my ends is cleaner than the other end too.
This is why we can't have nice things. So that pretty much covers like standard roof sizes. You know, the pitch or whatever you want to work with is all going to vary depending on the build. And of course, there's like my favorite roof, which is what I used over here in this thing I've been tinkering with, which is just slap a couple rectangles on it and say that's a roof with some little decorative stuff.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing.
Oh, okay.
Nothing at all.
That sounds like my style.
Yeah. I mean, for certain types of builds, that's all you need is, you know, a flat-topped roof, or, you know, throw some blocks up there if you're trying to make a castle or something.
Just make military barrack-style roofing.
Yep. So now we can start talking about some of the other types of roofing. the one thing about working with any kind of straight edge and making a corner out of a straight edge is that there's going to be overlap, gaps, and it's all about how do we want to deal with that, how do we want to try to mitigate it, and or how do we want to try to cover it up. Now, I use things like this a lot to make, like, lanterns for Japanese gardens, pagoda roofing and stuff like that, because honestly, I don't even try to cover up these edges.
I think they look cool.
Yeah. I mean, that's about as small as they're going to get. These are tilted on a 30-degree rotation all the way around, and all you got to do is, like, you put one down, you copy another one, and flip it one here. We'll just...
I was about to say, why don't you show us?
Yeah,
since
it's easier to show than try to tell in a case like this. So if I've got my rotation. I've got a rotation set. So I will just want to copy and paste it. I put a second one in. Now I just want to turn it around so that it's exactly the same as this one, but going in the opposite direction. I can click on, even if it's just one item, click on relative and as group. There we go. Crisis averted. I apparently had two of them selected and didn't catch it. Okay. So whatever. I've got my two here. So now I just need to make up the other two sides and copy and paste both of... copy and paste both of them on a 90-degree offset. And there they are. And as far as... I didn't do up any examples of pagoda roofing just because those are so kind of rare. Rarely done. And because those are such big item hogs. Pagoda roofs are huge item hogs just because of the way that they're shaped. Especially if you get real crazy with the arcs in the middles and in the middle of the roof and on each end. But actually you can kind of cheese some of those arcs by adding planks or whatever on the offsets on the ends of these triangles. So triangles are actually really, 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 really handy for a lot of things. Why are you hiding in there?
Shh. It's a surprise.
Okay. I set out the dome. I don't know if anyone really wants to...
Peek-a-boo.
I don't know if anyone really wants to discuss the how to
Peek-a-boo.
Do like a dome roof.
Have you not seen that video with the cute little bird playing peekaboo? Peekaboo!
No.
Oh.
So, I mean, if there's questions and anyone wants to talk about how to make something like this, I'm more than happy to talk about it. But otherwise, let me get started on the one that I've actually have been asked a lot about, which is this steeple here.
I actually did want to know about the dome, but that's okay.
Oh, well.
I'm okay. Stuck. I am so stuck in here.
That's what you get for acting. That's what you get for acting like a goober.
Shit.
Horse pokey.
You're going to help me out here.
The Taj roof, that one was an onion dome. And that one I talked about in the custom pivot tips and tricks, because I actually did not custom pivot this. This was all with the rotational offset. You could make it with custom pivot, but it was easier to do that way. But we're going to go back to the steeple. Hey, look, you made it. To Cooper. Okay, so I actually have had quite a few questions about how to make this particular roof right here. And I made a new version this morning, which is this one right here, and we'll cover that one next. So this one, because you can make cones, and if you make a round cone, especially with like, if you're talking poles, you're talking like 36 poles or more. Or it could be, it's if it's like corner posts, then you're talking about 60, roughly, depending on your rotation and if you care if the ends don't meet or not. But this one here, this particular one is 14 items. This one here, let's see, 4, 8, 12. Yeah, this one here is 4 per side. It's 4, 8, 12, 16, 18. That's a lot more doable. So how this works, take a triangle and you stand it up. Let me make sure I just have one. And then rotate it about 30 degrees. Now, clear that offset. Take a second one. And it's going to end up looking a lot like the Starfleet insignia. And then what we want to do is we want to try to get it to where we don't have too much, where you don't want the ends of the triangle piece poking out. Prickly just called me a nerd. Yes, pr and proud of it. And then do one at the bottom to fill it in. I think I actually did this one on a 20 degree. Yep, sure did.
I just realized I've been muted for a while. I was giggling so hard. I had to mute myself. So thank you, Prickly, because you vocalized what I apparently was not able to translate on mute.
What, that I'm a nerd?
I think it's just nerds. Oh my gosh. But you didn't huff at me, and I thought, well, that's awfully strange. Why is she being so mellow?
Because
Because
I'm
I
not
was
going to be
muted.
insulted about being called a nerd. I wear my hat proudly.
Ah, okay. Good for you.
So this is really big, but okay, so it's going to be easier for you to build it all while it's straight up and down. And this is going to put the gap at the top instead of at the sides and the bottom like this one. So now I can take this whole thing and then rotate it about 20 degrees. 'Cause when I tried rotating it more than that, I ran into problems where it did start getting a pretty significant gap at the side. So now, I mean, you don't have to do each side at a time. You could do it the exact same way you did the one. We did this one over here, but so copy all three pieces of the side and then just try to manually line it up until so that's, I mean, you can do some manual adjustments to try to get it to work out right, but this is basically how it's done. And then it puts this gap up here where it's easy to hide. You can slap a cube or sphere or whatever you want to plug that hole in the center, and then put a tile at the bottom. Oh, there you go, angry typing again.
Oh my God, I'm like 20 feet away. Oh, back to mute.
Then you can put a tile at the bottom to kind of cover up these overlays here, or the corners of these other triangles. Wow. I was actually thinking about putting them up on DA and then no one would have to buy it at all. Just saying.
Oh, well, just like, just give me a week. Just give me a week. Because the people that gotta have it right away will pay out the ass, and then you can put it up for free.
And then
I'll give you 20%.
also with one like this, because I saved this one as a set too, because I was like, holy crap, I don't ever want to do that again. If I'm going to use just the same thing, then I can, just use my group scale to make it bigger or smaller, and then just reuse the same thing without having to make it all over again. So when I said it was easy, I meant it. It actually is, pretty easy. Would you agree, or are you still on mute because you're anger typing some more?
Shit, that opened up like every freaking window possible and left. I should have used the number pad.
So, would you agree, though, that this was not hard? Prickly
Oh,
says,
it's gonna be super easy for me because I'm just copying all this
see,
shit.
Prickly agreed that it was easy.
Okay.
So, never mind.
Majority rules.
Yes.
Throw a punch or seven the majority.
So, with this one here, because you can, it's easy to do them around without. I would like to know about the round. Okay, I'll go to that one.
Oh, because they asked. We'll look at the round room, but
We'll get to that. I'm getting to that one here when I get done with these cones. For this one here, this is a little bit different than using the triangles. Again with the offsets. So if you want, say, something that's round that's on a steep angle and doesn't use 50 items, you can use planks to make these cones. And all I'm doing is copying and pasting one rib and then manually rotating it so that the ends don't have a lot of overlap. And it takes about 16 to 18 planks, depending on the angle of rotation. The wider the angle, the more planks it's going to take. And again, for just experimentation, I highly recommend plain wood, plain stone, whatever you can craft, because you don't know, especially if you're trying to figure out how many items something takes or if it takes a lot. And these don't take a long time either. And then once it's done, you save it as a set, copy and paste as necessary. Or, use the multi-item copy and paste, and that's a basic cone done with planks. Remember, do one rib and then copy and paste both pieces and just manually rotate them. Or do the trial and error to figure up the rotation to where the ends don't have a gap. So this one, or just by. Yeah. But, a stack of 99 wood planks is a whole lot cheaper than a stack of 99 limestone or something, unless you can find it on the auction house for cheap. So I have a fifth piece somewhere. Okay. Why did I do that? So let's go into this one. This one is 4 pieces per side. And it's the same basic principle as the other, as the one with the triangles. Except everything is on like a 10 degree arch or 10 degree curve, which will be in many boxes in March. The new stuff, the new building block textures are supposed to be in the building block in the minion boxes in March, but I mean, I don't know. I use blocks in bulk, and well, I mean, everybody's different. Okay, so copy.
Silver here over here can't wait for them to be in the mini boxes. She's got to get them now. Just that elite building skill.
No. Hey, 3 gold each for a wood plank. You know, I don't care about looking for wood planks on the auction house. Yeah. So to get this, you'd tilt in each side like 10 degrees. What are you doing?
It's an obstacle course. It's keeping me out of trouble.
No, it's not.
Bird butt, bird butt.
And I'm being a goober. Okay, so again, with the planks, if you want to say do something that's square but tall and narrow, so this is all rectangles and planks. Yeah. Prickly sister hopped up on goofballs today.
She said balls.
So with the, it's all about making it look kind of clean from the outside. If you're making ceilings or whatever, it doesn't matter what it looks like from the inside, because no one will be able to see that anyways. And then rotate that one. Son of a bitch.
Hey, language. This is a family show.
Yep. Well, when stuff doesn't want to all select, it's getting kind of irritating.
Do you need a Snickers?
No.
You need a hug?
So again, select all the pieces of the side and offset it 90 degrees. And this is a real shallow angle. It's only about 10 degrees.
We're so close. You can't run from me.
Holy crap, our hour is almost done already. Is it just me or did it go really quick?
It went pretty fast except for when I was stuck in that Sparta pit over
there.
Well,
you did that. That's a self-inflicted wound. And then, you have the hole at the top, but I just slapped some tiles down and that covered those up. And then you can put in little flags or whatever. And that makes that real easy. Again, I'm just going to say, experiment, fiddle with it, play around with different angles. Because alignment, the flicker, I cannot kill the flicker in this thing right here. And I don't know why. Adjust and adjust and adjust, and it still just flickers madly. So
it's just excited about how cool it looks. That's all.
So now we're going to talk about the round roof. I use this dome and variations of this dome a lot. You may see it in my contest build that I'm gonna open up tonight. And it's not hard either. If you take like a basic arch, let me just find it.
Did you just do a flip on that roof?
No.
Huh.
Might have, because Kalaria grow like that.
Oh, that looks so cool.
Oh,
Look
that's
like you're
not
doing
fun.
parkour.
Okay. I gotta send this one to the. So I'm going to start it off with a basic arch. That's only on like a 5-degree curve. I'm not going to talk about how to make things like arches and stuff today because, I mean, that's kind of that's a topic for a different time, is how to do things like arches. So to save off my item limit right off the top, because I like it with the hole in the center, I'm just going to take the two middle pieces out. Because these are a lot of items where the items don't come in at the edges, because you want to set it to where they're like just touching at the edge. But up here, you can see like there's crazy amounts of overlap. I didn't clean this up any trying to pull pieces. So you can do this with custom pivot, but it's also just as easy to do it this way too. Especially if you're not sure how many it's going to take. Now 10 of course goes into 360 36 times. But you're doing two sides at a time, so it's only going to be 18. And also when I'm doing it like this, I'm doing it just in case there's a mistake, because I don't really want to sift through 300 cubes to find the one that's doubled up. And if one makes a mistake, then it's a lot easier to fix when it's on one leg instead of after it's done and you're trying to figure out what's wrong. Might be about out of cubes too. And she just keeps doing it. But if you know how many pieces are, you can, how many sides are needed, then you can just offset multiple items and go. Or you can custom pivot it out. It's either way. And would probably be the smart thing to start pulling some of these excess pieces out as you go. But I don't ever do that. I just wait till it's done. Yeah, all right. I'm out of cubes. But anyways, that's how it's done. I'm just make an arch, any kind of arch that's roughly the size that you want on an angle of rotation that you want. This is only a 5-degree curve. So this is a pretty shallow dip. And then once you have, yes, you can go in with different color skins, but then once you have the whole thing set up, if you want to say pull, I always do like every other one at the top. Because no one's going to notice it. No one's going to notice it anyways. And then once you start getting down like here, where there's not too much overlap, if you're not sure, clear out all offsets and then just start picking pieces. So that way you don't have something catastrophic happen. I like leaving these the cutouts in Just because it looks interesting that way. And then it saves some items on something that otherwise, you know, would have used. So that gave away the secret of the dome. Of course, if you want an item-friendly dome, just use some Necropolis arches and spin them out, and then you don't need nearly that many. Because this is the tedious part of it comes when you're trying to pick out and get rid of some of the excess.
This looks freaking awesome. Totally stealing this. Totally.
You don't have to steal it. I just told you how to do it. Not only that, I just showed you how to do it.
But it would just be so much easier to steal it.
It starts out at about 360 items, Jade. And then once you...
Sweet Jesus.
With the center removed, once it first comes in, then it's about 280. And then once you start picking pieces, you can get it down to about 150. Yeah. That's why, I mean... And it looks cool from the inside. And then, you know, if somebody wants to jump up on top, it looks cool from the outside, too. And that's how it's done.
I'd like to point out how quiet my dogs have been mm-hmm. this entire duration. NyQuil works wonders.
They've been... Wow! I mean,
it's a liquid treat. Nom, nom, nom.
I mean, it's a lot of items, but I, you know, in the right... In the right kind of building, I think it's definitely worth it. Onion dome is like 360 before you start picking pieces out. But it's tedious to come in and start picking out like all the excess blocks. Yep, it's definitely giving me time.
What are we giving away today?
Same thing, we give away everything.
Is it snails or corgis?
It's corgis.
Alright, we're giving away the corgi pet, guys. If you want one, you can type anything in chat and you will be automatically entered to win. Hashtag peekaboo gets you extra entries.
Oh, really?
Peekaboo! I love how people that don't want it type in chat to say, I don't want it. All right, I'm going to give you guys about 15 more seconds. Peekaboo hype! All right, here we go. I have 12 users entered. Going to roll the first one. Congrats, Kula.
I don't know. He might have to give his to somebody else for that horrible joke.
Sea Mage.
What about Teridan? You to give it away
oh, now? Oh, what?
Teridan?
Yeah. Okay. Sparkland. Didn't you win last week? You're cheating.
You gave her your weighted dice.
Emprecale. See, told you it was all about the peekaboo.
Awesome. I'll send those out as soon as we get done. I think Kula said we need to reroll.
Reroll for his?
I guess.
All right, so Tassiera.
And she didn't want it either.
Son of a bitch. Red six. Do you want it, Red? I don't know why we do this. Oh my
Red six, yeah. Okay. Hey, you're welcome, Marth. Thank you. And again, if there's any questions, please ask. I honestly, I like building structures just about the best of all. Oh, Kula does want it.
Oh, hell no, homie. I just rerolled four times because you said pass. Now you want it back?
That's fine.
I'm charging you a restocking fee, bruh.
I mean, and then always just experiment, tinker, play around, even if you don't have a like a dedicated dimension for test building, play around in one when it's still empty. Most things don't take up a whole lot of items. I think the only way to get better at doing something is to practice and keep doing it until you get to where you want to be.
Oh, that was so inspirational.
Oh,
Blech.
that sounded like a lecture, and I'm sorry.
No, it didn't. It sounded very sensei-ish.
Right. So next week again, we'll be back at a later time, 2 p.m. server, to with the roadshow. We'll be on with Bella Rosa. We're going to be looking at the Radical Botanical Garden entries, and then after for the next tips and tricks, I have no idea what we're going to talk about.
So bring your bug spray and your allergy medicine.
And I hope there was some good information here. And I look forward to seeing many, many steeples in the future. So until next time, have a great weekend.
Bye.